those like will allow you to put in your flight number and see all the information about your flight. Everybody, welcome back to my channel. I am Alexia Nicole and I'm living my life by design. And y'all have seen Serena before.
Hi.
Hi. So Serena came up with a really good idea for a video. So we're going to go ahead and talk about that today. What are some of the most commonly used apps for flight attendants just living life that you can use on the plane or just whatever makes life easier for a flight attendant? So let's just go ahead and jump right on in. Popular apps used as a flight attendant.
Okay.
I don't really have a lot. Serena does though.
I have a lot. Okay, so with our airline, if you're on reserve, you're usually going to get assigned red eyes to Santo Domingo, Santiago. The
Serena's
DR, basically.
Still on reserve.
I'm still on reserve. I actually haven't flown there in a while, but I went to Cancun yesterday. And I flew back to Orlando, and I had to use my mobile passport.
Was that you were working a trip, or that was?
I just got done with a 3-day trip yesterday.
Oh, okay.
With mobile passport, you have like a PIN number where I put it in. You have to add your passport in it, and you take a picture of yourself. And this is easier than when you have to fill out your paperwork on the plane.
Yeah.
On the plane, or when you're in the customs room.
Mm-hmm.
All you have to do is select if you came in on an airplane or a ship. Select what city you're coming through and what airline you used.
Yeah.
And they give you a little receipt and you scan it at the kiosk and you show them your passport and then you're done. It's really quick.
That's it.
And super easy.
Yeah. So, yeah, instead of just going through the regular immigration's custom line and having to wait with all those people, download that app. Super, super easy.
Skipping a couple more steps.
Yeah.
It's like, it's in between paperwork and global entry.
Yeah. I don't have global entry. Do you have global entry?
I'm going to get it because one day my passport didn't work and
go
through it and I was like, oh my gosh.
Oh. So yeah, global entry is another one. That's not an app. That's something that you basically have to go somewhere, pay like $100 to get. Mm-hmm. Our airline actually reimburses you if you do decide to sign up for global entry. And yeah, it's just another speed through way of getting through customs.
Yeah.
So that's something you should look into once you get hired on with your airline. Or I guess you can just have it if you travel a lot.
Yeah.
You know, you don't necessarily.
In general, good.
Yeah.
But if you are, you know, just now starting off the airline and you plan to travel a ton, I would suggest getting one or the other because filling out all those forms is a lot.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely.
And it's overwhelming and it takes a while.
One of the apps that I use, and there's a lot of different ones that are very similar, but like Flight Aware,
mm-hmm.
Flight View, but basically those like will allow you to put in your flight number and see all the information about your flight. What altitude you're at, how much longer you have, the weather of your destination, so on and so on and so on. So I always use that app, you know, in flight because it's not always easy to talk to the pilots if they're doing whatever up there in their flight deck. You
yeah.
always have customers asking you, how much longer do we have on this flight? Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. So I just pull up the app and I'll say, okay, this is where we are.
You search your flight number, you select your flight, and it will show you where the airplane is, how much longer you have, the gate you're leaving, the gate you're coming into / terminal.
Yeah.
It will show you the route that your airplane is taking, and it'll even show you weather and the severity of it.
So there's a few different apps that basically do exactly the same thing.
And it's free. Anyone can have it on their phone. You don't have to be, you don't have to work in flight and be in aviation to log in or
just
anything.
Just download it. So if your boo or your husband, your kids are somewhere or going somewhere and you know, you may not be able to contact them on the phone, you can track their flight.
Yeah.
Simple as that. There's also another app called Flight Board where I use this one a lot during commuting. So if you are a commuter and you know your planned out route of getting back to base or getting home isn't necessarily working, this app you can put in the airport that you're at and it will show you a list of every flight that is departing or arriving at that airport in order of time.
Oh, so I want that app.
Yeah, download that app. It's called Flightboard. I think it's like a yellow and black picture or something. But it's really, really amazing. That day that I was stuck commuting in Houston, I was using that one to see when was the next flight going. And, what, you know, it doesn't show you loads. I wish that's an app that somebody needs to create, is one that has loads for every airline. But that's really going to be hard because you can't really just have access to every airline's
You can
loads.
See on some airlines, like Delta American, you can see how many seats are sold, but for us, we don't know how many people are on standby.
And things like that.
Like, there'd be 30 people, and you would not have any idea until you get there.
Those are some apps that you can use, you know, just in flight and things like that, if you're trying to commute. There's just other apps in general that I really like to use. Amazon. One of my favorites.
Everything.
You know, your
list.
Yeah, like literally, like I was flying the other night and I just realized that I was out of something and I was like, okay, I'll be back home in 2 days. I'm not going to want to go to the store. So let me just order it on Amazon and have it delivered right there, as long as the people in my building are not taking my packages. Been having issues, y'all. But other than that, you know, Amazon is great. It has everything that you need. Delivers right there, boom, gets your 2-day shipping and call it a day. Amazon Prime
is worth it.
Yeah, I use my sister's, but whatever.
Also, of course, like Uber and Lyft. Mm-hmm. And then if you're in New York and if you're traveling to visit New York, or if you are a New York flight attendant, also NYC Airporter, which is when you get to a terminal at JFK. They have a bunch of shuttles that will take you to either Manhattan, or they'll take you back to a different terminal or to a different airport, like LaGuardia or something.
I've never heard of this one.
Yeah. They usually only take cash, or you can have the app and put your card in and do it through that, through like email or something, have a receipt, and then you just show it to them. It's way cheaper than taking an Uber, actually, but the shuttle will take you, like, to places in Manhattan and different boroughs.
Hello, Serena, put us up on game.
So if you're visiting and your hotel is in downtown, just go get this app and get on the shuttle, and it will take you down there instead of taking a $50 Uber or Lyft.
NYC Airporter.
Yes.
Okay. So what else do you use? I've pretty much told y'all everything that I use. Our airline does have an app specifically for us that I use a lot as well. It allows us to check in, see what gate we're supposed to be reporting at. It has our schedule and all of that stuff. I'm pretty sure every airline has their own app that, you know, if you're working for the airline.
I obviously have Yelp because I want to check out different restaurants when I'm in different cities.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I also have Mint, which is
Mint.
To help you keep in your
financially budgeting app. That's a really good one.
Tell you what you're spending and stuff.
Yeah.
Because I'm really bad about it, and so I'm trying to get it together.
Okay, yeah. So Mint, you can like put in any type of financial institute that you're with, even if it's just 401k, your regular bank, car note, like all of this stuff. You can show all of your bank statements, not statements, but you know, your
how you're spending balances. Your money, where you're spending it.
Shows all your
habits
balance.
You have.
Yep.
Shopping, eating out, transportation. It shows all of that in like a pie circle, and it'll show you how much, like, for me, it's like this much on on like food, and like this much on shopping, and this much.
It's
on
really, really great at helping you budget. You can also put in when your bills are due and things like that, and set up automatic payments. Like, it's a really, really good app to use. It shows you your credit score as well. If you're into being better financially, that's a really good one to use. I also recently downloaded Acorn. That's more of like a savings app.
How do you feel about that?
I mean, it's not bad. So the way Acorn is set up is that every time you swipe your card, whatever card you have connected to it, so if I spend $5.50 at the bodega down the street, it's gonna round up to the nearest dollar, so that'll be 50 cents. It's gonna send it over to Acorn, and it's going to start a savings for me. So once the savings gets to a certain amount, it will invest that money into something that they think it's worthy for.
So, I have a Roth IRA.
Yeah.
And a financial advisor.
Do you now?
I do.
All right, too fancy. Serena over here trying to get rich. I think that's another good one. Bank of America had an account very similar to that, that it would round up to the next dollar, and then it would put my money in my savings account. So this one rounds up, and it doesn't go into a savings account. It goes to Acorn, and then they invest it into whatever company or something like that.
Probably like Disney or like just huge corporations like Sony. Yeah.
So that's just money that you don't even realize is gone, honestly. And I think I've been using it for like 2 weeks, and I have about $50 or something in there right now.
Oh my gosh.
I swipe a lot. So if you're like me, if you're a swiper,
maybe I should get that.
Yeah. And then if it's an even amount, like if it's $17, it's going to put a dollar over there. It's not going to just leave it alone. It puts a dollar, so it rounds it up to $18. I was like, wait, where are all these dollars coming from? But yeah, so that's just a really good way of savings.
I also just downloaded Instacart, which we were just talking about.
Yeah. Go ahead. I haven't downloaded that, so I might if it sounds good.
So when I was a nanny, the family I worked for, the mom always used Instacart, and I had never heard of it before that time. And so she would be at home just adding things, like walking around the kitchen and adding things that were like low or missing. And I was like, oh, it's not really necessary for me because I can just go to the grocery store, like I have time. Well, now, since I'm in New York and I don't have a car, and I'm trying to budget my money better, I kind of was like thinking, oh, well, I don't want to spend money on a Lyft or Uber to go to the grocery store and come back, and I don't want to just buy stuff impulsively. So with Instacart, you just put in your zip code. It will give you a few stores to select from. I think you can have stuff delivered from multiple stores if you wanted. And it will show you things that are on sale. It will show you coupons that are available. And then you can look in your cart, look over all your items, how much you're spending on each, and then your total. And I think that's really helpful because then you can, if you're a meal prepper or something, you can just be very strict with yourself and say,
oh my gosh,
I need like quinoa, chicken breast, and like broccoli.
I need that for my 30 for 30.
Yeah. Instead of like, you know, you're walking to the store and you're like, oh, this looks good. These, I'm gonna get some cookies for a day. I'm gonna need it, and just toss it in there. Just things that you don't actually need, but you just want in the moment. Like for me, I usually get like pasta, vodka sauce, and tuna, and I have a meal for like 3 days.
So how long does it take for them to deliver?
An hour to 2 hours.
Really? It's that quick?
Yeah, and they'll tell you the time slots of when people are gonna go to the store and pick up your groceries.
Oh, wow.
I usually will get, like, grilled cheese supplies and, like, and petite carrots and stuff. Just things that are quick that I can make before I go on a trip, or if I'm just kind of lazy and I can just throw it together, I have it and it's at my crash pad available for me. Instead of, you know, buying a tub of ice cream because it looks good.
It looks good in the moment, right?
Yeah, and it helps you keep yourself more strict because you're like, I'm not going to buy anything unhealthy because it's going to get delivered to me.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah.
So what else you got over there? Anything else?
I have Game Time.
What's that?
Game Time is wherever you are, it will show you events that are happening in your city. So like basketball games, baseball, football, like sports events.
Nah, I don't need that. But if you're into that.
If you're into it, yeah. And it, you're like, have a $20 Brooklyn Nets versus Knicks game.
Well, I might go. Hey, you know.
I don't use it all the time, but if I'm off in the city and I don't have anything to do, I'll check it out and see what's going on.
Just go, yeah. All right. Well, I think that's about it. I mean, other than your basic social media apps, that's all we got for you. So we hope you enjoyed that video. Download some of those apps if you think they sound interesting for your lifestyle. Till next time, don't forget to subscribe, like, and share.